start again on this special series, Removing the Stone. If you have watched the previous videos, I'm sure you have discovered things about yourself that you were not aware of. And it has been like an eye-opener, right? And today we are going to speak about something else. We are going to remove another stone, which is called hypocrisy. Now, when you hear about hypocrisy, you for sure, maybe you did like this, no, hypocrisy, I'm not a hypocrite. Because often we like to have this great image about ourselves. We justify ourselves by the things we do, the good things we do, the way we handle our life. And sometimes that's what the problem is. Sometimes we are so busy doing so many things that we don't have time to examine ourselves and see the things, the ugliness inside of us, especially with our actions and reactions. The reactions actually speak a lot of what is inside of us, which is more important. We often have our eyes focused on what we see, and we don't look at what we don't see, that is really what is inside of us. Our eyes point out to the outside, so we tend to see things physically. But what really matters is not the things that are around us. What matters is what is inside of us, the attitudes, the ugliness inside of us, that sometimes it becomes a problem, not only to our spiritual life, but also to the people we live with, right? So I would like to read here in the dictionary the meaning of hypocrisy, what the dictionary says about hypocrisy. It's a pretense of having a virtuous character, moral, or a religious beliefs or principles that one does not really possess. Now, when I read this, the first thing that comes to my mind is a fake person, right? A person that appears to be someone who is not, is fake. And it comes to my mind straight away, fake profiles. It's so common nowadays for people to have more than one profile on social media, because there are things they want to show to a group of people, and these things they don't want to show to the other group of people, so they create many profiles, and some of them fake profiles, to pretend to be a person that they are not. And this is a problem. This shows there is a lack of sincerity. There is a lack of honesty. So why do we have to keep several profiles, different profiles, or fake names? Why is that? You need to consider that. There must be a reason. You need to ask the question, why do I need a fake profile? Could this be because you are being fake? You are pretending to be someone, but you are not that person. You wish to have this image of yourself, but inside you are not that person. It could be. Oh, another thing that we see very often nowadays, and people don't realize, for example, when they have a problem, not a problem that just came and you are handling it, but the problem that is insisting, you know, is there for a long time, and you have tried everything within your power to resolve this problem, but you couldn't. But you feel too ashamed to go and seek for help. Why you feel ashamed? Because you don't want to lose face. You are keeping up the appearance that everything is perfect, and this could be in different areas, could be in your finances, You made a poor decision and this has brought a problem that you don't see an end to that. It could be a problem in your relationship, in your marriage. It could be a problem maybe with someone else. And you are trying to live life pretending it doesn't exist, pretending to have this perfect image. But inside closed doors is a big problem. You take selfies with your partner, with your husband, and you post there beautiful quotes and you appear to people that you are perfect, but your marriage is breaking down. You are on the verge of divorce. So what you have to do, you need to seek for help. You cannot keep up appearances forever. If you keep up a good appearance, the moment the problem cannot be contained anymore, everybody will see it anyway. The shame will be much greater because you faked for so long. Right? So what is the best thing to do? Put your pride aside. Go and seek for help. It doesn't matter what kind of help you need, but go and seek for help. There are people that are suffering seriously from depression, but they can't speak up about that because they think that they have to keep up appearances. Nobody will understand them. If it's killing you, if it's destroying within, let's resolve it. Do not allow these keeping up appearances to impede you to find happiness. Do you understand? Another thing we see a big problem, a fake thing as well. For example, people, they keep hidden relationships, whether it is you are married and you have a hidden relationship, or maybe you are in the church for a long time, you have heard the advice, not of the church, but actually the Word of God teaches that you should not get involved with people that are unbelievers. But you are there keeping up a relationship, hiding a relationship. But you need to understand that the reason why the Bible teaches us that a Christian should not marry an unbeliever is not because you are better than them. No, we are not better. But simply because the principles are different, and there will be one day you will start to have clashes. And if you get married, you know that marriage, or you will compromise your faith, you will let go of your faith once and for all, or your marriage you are gonna have big problems in your marriage. So, but because you don't wanna lose maybe a position in the church, maybe you don't wanna lose face before other people, you are hiding that relationship. But this is also called hypocrisy. Every time we pretend to be something that we are not, that is hypocrisy. Sexual immorality, you know, nowadays people, they don't need to actually have sex with someone. Sexual immorality already starts in here. You see a man or a woman, I don't know. You see and you fantasize about that person. And you leave that fantasy in your mind all the time. In your before other people, you don't say it. You don't speak about that. In fact, sometimes you even give good advice to other people. But for yourself, you still keep fantasizing about that. Maybe you are watching pornography. You think that it's not so harmful. There will not be consequences of that. You hide it. You masturbate. You know you should not touch yourself, but you do it. You keep up appearances. You before other people, you see, I'm okay, I'm handling it well. but inside you are not handling it well. You are leaning towards what is ungodly, and you need to be careful with that. Other things that we see, for example, people that don't handle well discipline, whether be it parents, spouse, in the church, when you are being disciplined, you appear to accept it, but inside of you, you don't accept it. Everybody, when you are being disciplined, everybody sees you accepted it, but inside of you, your reaction, maybe you don't show, but your inner reaction is to justify your error, is to say, it's not really like that. You don't understand me. So what is that? You are not handling well yourself, your emotions. And your other thing is having split personalities. Before some people you behave in one way, and before others you behave in a different way. With some people, that you can get some benefits, you are very respectful, you are very calm, collected person. But when you are with people that cannot give you any kind of reward, you have this personality that you seem like a completely different person. You are angry, you have outbursts of anger, you cannot control your temper, you the words you say is very evil, cursing words. What is this? Hypocrisy. You know, all these that I'm talking about, and surely all the stones you have heard on the previous videos, you need to know something. We are all, including myself, we are all capable of doing that. The problem is when we put our guards down, when we convince ourselves that we are these holy people, these good people, then that's the problem. That's, we are a step away from committing one of those sins, having one of those stones inside of us, leading us to lose our salvation. Now, one day, Jesus was teaching the disciples the following. Take heed that you do not do your charitable deeds before men to be seen by them. Otherwise, you have no reward from your Father in heaven. Therefore, when you do your charitable deed, do not sound the trumpet before you as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may have glory from men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward. But when you do your charitable deed, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, that your charitable deed may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will himself reward you openly. Now, this is what you need to understand. Everything you do, it needs to be done for God. Even your good works, even your hard work, everything you do, it needs to be for God. Not expecting any reward, not expecting the respect of people. But what you do, you need to do it for God, to honor God, because the reward comes from Him. If you do something for people, you have a good character and behavior before people, just because you are expecting some sort of benefit, then you will not receive the reward from heaven. And what is the reward that God gives us? The reward that God wants to give us is the Holy Spirit. It's not a blessing in the family or a blessed love life, blessed finances, or a blessing, a great job, work, you having your own business. This is not a reward. These are blessings. Blessings, they come, but when you die, they stay. What is eternal is what is inside of you. So what is this reward? The reward is the Holy Spirit. So if you have been seeking and you have not received the Holy Spirit, do a serious self-examination and see where you have been failing. And cast away those stones. And surely God will give you the reward, which is the Holy Spirit. Eternal life and salvation with Him. See Him face to face in heaven. That's what I would like to share with you. And until next time, make sure you keep hypocrisy away from you. Take away that stone, because it may seem small to you, but it's not a small thing. It's a big thing. It's like when you are wearing your shoes and there is a little stone inside of your shoe. It doesn't matter how small it is, it's gonna cause damage, right? In the same way, the stone of hypocrisy can cause serious damage to the point that sometimes you cannot be repaired anymore. So let's remove the stone of hypocrisy so that we can receive the reward from God, the Holy Spirit. Until next time, stay in faith. Bye-bye.